When you know clearly what you do want, the source energy part of you turns its undivided attention to that new conclusion and that new decision. And in that moment, the universe through you has expanded into yet an improved place. But most of you, bless your hearts, don't ride that rocket of desire. Most of you don't go with that expansion. Most of you stand in this place of defending why you need or want something better. You say, as if you were pleading to your mother, you did that when you were little, I need it, I really need it. Mother, I really want this. Well, we all want things, son. You don't get what you want. Many mothers say that, misguided beings that they are. You don't get what you want. Well, I need it. Oh, well, that's different. How badly do you need it? I will die if I don't have it. As you plead your neediest cases, that's when Congress puts the money there. That's when your mother gives up the goods. That's when people who are weary of your complaining cave in and say, all right, take the car. But we're wanting you to understand that even though humans may cave in to your negative demands or pleading, the universe never ever gives you what you want when you're beating the drum of what you don't want. Every time you are justifying how much you need something, you are vibrationally preventing yourself from having what you want. You cannot offer the frequency of need and desire at the same time. You cannot be a vibrational match to what you want and its absence at the same time. More often than not, when you have been without something that you want for a while, when you talk about it, you usually talk about it from your disappointed place of not yet having it. And what we want you to come to remember as a result of our conversation here today is that that disappointment that you feel is your indicator about which end of the stick you are vibrating on. Because every subject is two subjects, what you want and lack of it.